Okay.
This is just a really quick video about the Sengbusch self-closing inkwell. And I got a chance, I filled this guy up, have not used it. You can tell the top isn't even black yet. I filled it up to about a half an inch or so from the top with some Pelican ink that I got laying around, which I want to get rid of. And you can see it's not black all the way on the top. The top plunges up and down. In the video I did just before this, I tried putting some water in it, and you can't tell. So I put a whole bunch of ink in it, about a half an inch from the top, and you can actually see the level on the side, which is nice. I'm not going to tip it over and show you that. So it's floating. The center part floats up when there's enough ink, and or when it's in the chamber, because there's a chamber with a piece of glass at the bottom, and the glass moves as well as the float. The float, when you press it down, is meant to allow the ink to get on the pen, and then when you let up, it comes back up so it's not evaporating. So, let's see if we get ink on our pen. How about that? A little. Maybe our chamber has to fill up a little. Because I know it had tiny holes. Oop. So it's getting black, I can tell that. So this is the first dunk. Now this is one of my favorite writers. This is a Mitchell writer, and it's got an extended reservoir, which is nice because it writes a little fat. First dunk of the Sengbusch, what do I call it? Self-closing? Inkwell. Oh, and it also, because it stops when you put it down in there, make sure you get the exact right amount of ink on here. You're actually only, You're actually only supposed to have ink up to the last of the hole that splits the nib. So this is how much we can write. Oh, I love this. Just one dunk. Now I'm using crappy paper that's bleeding like crazy. It's soaking up the ink. It's not like a high quality paper. I'm just throwing it on here because I'm just dying to see how it works. And I'm looking, and sure enough, it's sealed all the way around. And because the float comes up to the top, the fluid that was left gives it this airtight seal. So the only thing that's exposed is a little bit of ink that was just covering the very top of this float. So if you looked at it, it's this float that sits inside this little mechanism with feet on it. And in here, in that little, oh, you can't even see that, can you? Oh, here I am drawing something you can't see. There you go. This is what this little guy, this little piston, is what's going up and down. So when I dunk it in and bring it back up, that little guy comes back up, and I can see I got about a quarter of an inch of ink on here. So that's it. And the top has this hole, and there's the lid. Oh, this looks just like a photograph, doesn't it? And this guy, let's make him black, that's what comes up to this point right here. This thing works really good. I'm just looking at it. It must be from the 20s or 30s. I mean, it's just fantastic. And it was so clean when I got it. Clean. I mean, there was no ink residue, no nothing. I put hot water through it. Fabulous. So look at this. Look how well I'm doing on that same dip. This is great. Oh, started to run out. Not bad for one dip, right? There you go. Absolutely fabulous. Made in the USA, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Patented August 23rd, 1904, January 15th, 1907. And this is a bit of American ingenuity that I'm really happy to have on my desk. Oh, that's so cool. And that's it. From the sales engineer, I just wanted to show you this fabulous catch. Phenomenal.